Hi guys, today we will see what is load and startup tag available in web.xml. We will also see what is this tag, why we should use this tag, and what are the different scenarios where it can have different values like 0, negative value or positive value, or it could have a same value for two different servlets. Then what is the result out of that? How does server behave and what's the guarantee provided by Java Enterprise Edition specification or server? So we are going to see all those such cases. Let's move on. First of all, why we should use this? Because we can use this for performance reasons, because whenever request comes, I do not want my server to create the servlet instance at that time. Otherwise, my first request always will be, it will take a little more time than subsequent requests. So what I can do is I can ask my server to load the servlet or create the instance of the servlet or call the init method of the servlet in the server startup itself. So let's see what Java EE specification talks about load and startup. It says that this is the XML element, and it can have a different value, like it can have negative value or it can have zero, positive, or the value for load and startup tag for two servlets can be same value or it can be different. So we will talk about all those such cases, and this is all what we are going to talk about in our demo part. And if you see, if you read this the specification, let me tell you that you do not have to watch my video also, because this will cover everything. But yeah, if you don't want to read this and you want to see the demo right away, let's move on, and then you can come back to this place anytime. We will see all the cases where there is no load and startup present, or if it is present but it's negative, or if it's present but it's zero or positive, or there are two servlets and then both the servlets have same load and startup value. So we will see what is the behavior of a server here. What are the guarantee server can give, in which cases, how server will behave. We will see all that, and then what is the guarantee from Java EE specification which server has to follow. We will see all the such cases. So let's first see a case where there is no load and startup tag present in web.xml for one particular servlet. So for simplicity, I've created two servlets, and I have overridden init method with one sysout in servlet 1 and servlet 2, and these two servlets are mapped in web.xml. Load on startup element or tag is present for servlet 1 with having value 1, and there is no load on startup present for servlet 2. So let's see, if it is not present, what should happen to servlet 2 initialization at the time of server start. As you can see that there is only one init method called for servlet 1 because it was present with value 1, and there is no load and startup present for servlet 2, so it is not called. Now let's see if it is 0. And this is 1. So in this case, first servlet 1 will be loaded, I mean initialized, and then servlet 2. Let's verify. You can see here, first servlet 1 is loaded and then servlet 2. Now let's see a scenario where we will give minus 1 and another is 1. You can see that only init method of servlet 2 is called, because another one had minus 1 for servlet 1. So if it is minus 1, server will ignore that servlet to start at the server booting time. Now let's see if they have the same value, which is 1. So what happens? So as per specification, there is no guarantee that which servlet will be loaded first, but it all depends on server implementation. You can see that sequence is servlet 1 and then servlet 2, but it's not guaranteed. So we have talked about all those such scenarios. Thanks for watching my video. If you did not like this video, please let me know by providing your comments in YouTube video. And if you really liked it, then please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. We'll meet again in my next video. Thank you.